Good morning, everyone. So we are going to start with the new application, which is Visual Basic for Applications, VBA. Now, what is VBA? We'll start with a basic introduction first, obviously. Now, it is a programming language which is used to develop programs within Excel, Word, Access, etc. Basically, we'll use it for Excel. Basically, an easy language. Generally, people call VBA to be the back end of Excel. Now, why it is back end of Excel? So, what do you see when we did Excel? What do you see is the Excel view. We call it Excel view. The grid lines which you all saw, on which we did many of the calculations and all. So, that is the Excel view. Now, the back end, which is the VBA, is the place where we do the coding. Now, why we use that coding? For example, there are certain set of calculations which need to be performed continuously for a repeated number of times, maybe every month or maybe every week by a particular company or institute. So what they do is, instead of each time executing the same in Excel, they write certain codes so that you just need to input certain values and output will be automatically calculated each time. So for that we use VBA. Now, we give Excel instructions in this VBA language. Basically, we write the code and Excel will do what we will tell it to do. The set of instructions that we give to Excel is in the VBA language is called a macro. So whatever coding we do is known as macro. Now, there are two ways on how to record a macro. We'll do that later on when we proceed with the course. Basically, what happens is एकदम ईजी लैंग्वेज में हाउ डू वी अंडरस्टैंड वी बी ए इज दैट हम एकदम ईजी करने के लिए अपने सारे एक्टिविटीज़ को विच वी परफॉर्म रेगुलरली वी राइट सर्टन अमाउंट्स ऑफ कोड यूजिंग वी बी ए लैंग्वेज एंड देन विच इज़ नोन एज मैक्रो एंड देन दैट इज़ बींग परफॉर्म्ड ऑन द एक्सेल. नाउ वॉट आर द यूजेस ऑफ वी बी ए? So these are very simple. It helps in automating the tasks that we perform frequently, which I have just said, performing a set of calculations again and again. Let's say suppose a sales manager is being asked to give the sales data for each week or each month, and on basis of that certain analysis is being done. So instead of all the time inputting the data and then carrying out the analysis, you just need to write a VBA code, and then once the sales manager input that particular data in Excel, the output will automatically be calculated using the VBA. It allows us to create a custom command for specific tasks to be performed in Excel. Custom command meaning we learn this, that we make certain command buttons. Let's say suppose I need to calculate some marks. So I'll just create a button so that the person who is inputting the marks will just input the marks and will just click on that particular button and the calculations will be performed itself. So we do not need any such human intervention while the calculation is being done. Only for the information, only for the input, we require the human intervention. So it is known as a custom command for specific tasks. For certain specific tasks you perform, you create certain buttons. Using that button, you can perform that particular task very easily in Excel. Anyone can perform without even knowing that what all codes he is running or what are the functions he is performing. Just he is only concerned with the output, and he'll get the output using that custom command. Next is, it enables us to create a simplified and interactive front end. Now, as I told you right now, basically when you just are concerned with the output, then you don't require the how the calculations are done and what are required while the calculations are done. So you just require the front end, which is the output. And for that, you use VBA. Like people who do the coding, people who are, basically they deal with research and then analysis, those people write the code, and the managers who are only concerned with the final output, they just get the front end of it and they don't want to see the coding because they are just concerned with the output. we can create a platform for the end users, say, to take inputs and then perform actions based on those inputs. So the managers who are only concerned with the output, the input is being given, maybe interest rates, change in interest rates and how it will affect the overall profit. So all those inside calculations the manager don't want. The manager does only wants the final output. So that will be given in a simplified way. Just manager needs to change certain inputs and output will be shown to the manager. It can also help us in inserting customized text strings, which we'll do. Basically, in some places we'll see that one particular text string is required in each page. Let's say suppose a marks is being written, a report, maybe a class teacher is preparing report card for 40 students. So one particular text string is required in all the 40 report cards. So for that, the teacher can use this VBA and all the 40 report cards will contain those particular text strings which are required. So basically these are the basic uses of VBA. And just what I want to tell you all is, in this particular first video, in the coming videos, we are going to make VBA so simple, we are going to make it so simplified that you don't have to worry anything about that, you're learning something new, it is a coding language, you need to write several codes. It's not like that. It's going to be very simple and we're going to proceed very, very slowly, and you just need to be on the track with my classes, go and perform all the assignments and do your homework, and whatever is done in the class, just go and revise that. It will be very easy for you all. VBA will become very easy for you all. In the next video, which is about how VBA came into its being. So this was the basic introduction of VBA, and I hope, don't get scared of VBA. It's very simple and it's very, very interesting, and we are going to make it full of fun. We'll make the learning very amazing and you're going to enjoy VBA. Thank you.